Hi everyone, I hope you enjoyed my London video and finally getting to the Rome video now. I just had so many clips to organize and I'm still going through the Switzerland one and the Holland one. So forgive me for this very long delay. I will get all the videos out, so don't worry. For this video, I have a little bit of narration as I'm doing now because I am not a great documentarian. I wasn't filming all the time. I don't really have a lot of transitions between things because I didn't know how I was putting things together or when I was filming anything. And so I thought this might be the easiest way to just pop in once in a while and explain something. So, hello, let's get started. First, I'm starting with the places Audrey lived whenever she was in Rome. I kind of forgot to go film the Hotel Hassler for you. I had passed by earlier on my trip and shared it on my Instagram, and then I guess thought that I had recorded it for this, and I did not. But the Hotel Hassler is at the top of the Spanish Steps, and she stayed there when she was filming Roman Holiday. Sorry, I'm slouching here because... anyway, yeah, just using the computer camera for this. I'm slouchy, sorry. So yes, she stayed in the Hotel Hassler while filming Roman Holiday, and that's at the top of the Spanish Steps. So that's easy to find. But I'm sorry, I don't have any video of it. You'll have to go Google it. Yeah, so there's that. Next, I have, my first clip is the street I believe she lived on when she first got married to Dr. Andrea Dotti. So here's that. All right, after doing a bit of detective work, this is as far as I've got figuring out where Audrey lived when she first moved to Rome after getting married. I believe the apartment would have belonged to her husband's family, and it was somewhere over here. She described it as being near Ponte Vittorio, a top floor apartment with a divine terrace, and her bedroom window looked out over Castel Sant'Angelo, which is right behind me over here. So. Couldn't narrow it down enough to get an address, but I'm pretty sure it's one of those. You could also perhaps be over there. I can't remember if she specified if it was on the same side of the river or not. I'm pretty sure it was over on this side, but. Never know. Could be over there. Really lovely around here, and you've got the Vatican over there. While we're in the area, I thought I would share this clip of the Saturday night dancing by the castle for you, since it's kind of Roman holiday-ish. I love that they still have dancing going on there. I mean, for the movie, I'm sure that was totally staged, but it's nice if you want to do a Princess Anne going out and dancing, swing dancing by the castle. You can on Saturday night. Where Audrey lived. After moving out of that apartment somewhere on that street, Audrey and her husband, I don't know if they had Luca at that point yet, but anyway, they moved to an apartment farther north in Rome, very close to where I was staying actually. So, right up the street. It's a nice quiet neighborhood, not a lot going on, but not far from Rome. It's a not a bad walk or quick drive if you want to do that. So here is her second residence in Rome. So this is where Audrey lived with her second husband. So you may have heard of this farmhouse called Villa Roli, as it's usually known. It has a couple other names that I've found, but that seems to be the most common one used. It was an old farmhouse with a distinctive pool in the Albano region south of Rome, where Gregory Peck stayed while filming Roman Holiday. And then Audrey spent her honeymoon with Mel Ferrer there. And also returned later while filming War and Peace. So it's a place she seemed to really like. I gathered a lot of clues about where this place might have been. And a friend and I drove down to that area south of Rome for a couple hours one day, just trying to see if we could speak to any locals who might recognize some pictures or the name of it. Just see if we could find it. The pool was very distinctive, so we thought perhaps someone would know. Perhaps it was turned into a hotel or something. But we didn't have luck. We didn't find it. But I'm going to share the video anyway, just because you can see the region. And yeah, I'm going to kind of keep looking for it. Maybe it still exists, and I think it would be fun to find. I'll go back another time and explore more in depth. So here's my little journey, my quest to find the farmhouse. So today I'm on a quest. Let's see how successful it is. Outside of Rome, in the Albano area. I'm with a friend, and we are trying to look for the farmhouse Audrey Hepburn stayed in twice, I believe, and Gregory Peck also stayed there while filming Roman Holiday. So, it's out there somewhere. Wish us luck! We've been looking, we've been asking around, but no luck yet. Got some nice views up here, though. Some nice wineries, but no luck yet. No one has heard of it. No one recognizes the pool. I mean, we've only asked a couple people, so not the whole town or anything. So we'll see. There's a lake over there. Yes, you can see the lake. Food truck. The bulk of my video here. We're going to cover a lot of the Roman holiday sites, so I definitely have to follow my notes here. let's see, chronological order we're going. We're just going to follow the movie. I was kind of hopping around different days, different places, so yeah, it's not chronologically in the order that I visited them, but we're just going to go follow the order that they appeared in the movie. So that's how we're doing this. There were a couple places I had on my list that I didn't make it to, like the, what's it called, the Wall of Wishes. I had mapped out where it was, and I really wanted to make it there. I know, I'm so lazy. I had a month. It was really hot, you guys. So it was a little discouraging to go outside and just immediately start sweating. And I also just wanted to relax and get to know Rome. So yeah, I missed a couple places on this trip, and the Wall of Wishes was one of them. So sorry about that. That was on the list, but I just can't do everything. So I hope what I have suffices to entertain you. All right, so let's see. First, the gate to the palace. This was, I didn't even write it down. Galleria Barberini. This was where they filmed the outside, the outside of the palace at the beginning of the movie and at the end. And as a bonus, even though they didn't film in there, I'm going to take you inside. You'll get a private tour from Princess Anne herself. All right, so here's an exterior you might recognize. One of the palaces used for Princess Anne's visit to Rome. And today, I'm gonna go shoot some pictures inside. Inside the Galleria. Just giving you a look. Even though they didn't shoot anything inside here. Come visit. Next, on our way to the place where Joe finds Princess Anne. Well, this is where Joe found Princess Anne, on a bench that no longer exists. So sorry, it's dark now. But you got the pretty lights on the palace. I was hoping maybe I could get a picture over here, but there are no benches. There's this thing now. Metro? Stop? Don't know what this is. No bench. I can't lay down on the bench. Kinda sad about that. I was gonna just find someone to take my picture. since I'm alone now. But no bench. I'm sorry guys. I really wanted to recreate that one. But actually, there's this bench here. But I feel the effect would not be the same. sorry, I think this is really pretty. I can't stop looking at it. So sorry, it just gets darker and darker, doesn't it? Nighttime. I wanted to show you the rest of
although you can't see it very much. I'll just have to visit for yourself, because I'm leaving in a couple days. Lots of traffic for the area. Some things under construction. It's nice and quiet back here. Nice place to hang out, like those guys.
Okay, so Via Margutta 51. I went twice. The first time I had this plan. There's this gallery in there, and I checked the hours online and thought I would go while they were open. Turns out nothing is open in August. Silly me. So I was ringing the bell, and nothing was happening, but a resident was coming out, and I told him I was trying to check out the museum, the gallery. And he let me in to the courtyard. So I went in and just checked the gallery. Yes, it was closed. And then took out my camera and filmed a little bit in there until someone else was coming down the stairs. And then I just felt really awkward and skedaddled out of there. Because I just felt like I was intruding. But yeah, so that was the first trip. The second time I was with a photographer taking some Roman holiday pictures. So I was in costume. And another resident was coming out at the same time we were at the door. And she asked him, in Italian, I don't know exactly what she said, but she asked if we could go in and just take some pictures. And he said yes. And yeah, we went in there for a couple minutes and took some quick pictures. Can't wait to share them. And then I took a little bit more video. And... got out of there quickly because we didn't want to, you know, get kicked out. We wanted to be quick and quiet and respectful. So anyway, these are the short videos that I took at Via Margutta 51.
The art gallery's closed, so I don't know. Maybe I'll email them. Let's see when they're open. I'm in Via Margutta 51 again. Quickly. And the stairs that we can't go up, but you get to see it. So, all right.
Next, Princess Anne heads to the barber. The barber is located right next to the Trevi Fountain. It is now... I guess you would call it a leather goods shop, purses and belts and stuff like that. But let's pretend it's a barber for now. At the Trevi Fountain now, can you hear me? Over to my left is what was the barber shop in Roman Holiday. Now they sell purses and belts, so you need a purse or a belt. And with a fresh haircut, Princess Anne heads to the Spanish Steps, which I actually totally neglected to show in my video. I thought I did take a video of it, but wow, the whole time I was there, no, I can't find video of the Spanish Steps. And the day I was there in costume, of course, I was with a photographer and we were taking pictures. It was early in the morning and we were also being very cautious because they have new rules about sitting on the stairs and they have guys, guards with little whistles and, you know, shooing people off. So we were trying to be quick. And so I forgot to take video. But you know what the Spanish Steps look like, right? Sorry about that. I did take pictures. I do have pictures. So go to Instagram because you'll see some awesome pictures of this whole thing. I have a whole series covering Roman Holiday. Well, depends when you watch this. October 2019, I will be posting all these photos. So, exciting.
Good morning from the Piazza di Spagna, I think. Spanish Steps behind me there. Here this morning, 8 a.m., bright and early, to meet my photographer of the day, and we're gonna take some photos here. hopefully they'll let me prop myself on the steps. They have this thing about sitting on the steps now. And then we're going to go to the Mouth of Truth, and then I'm going to take myself to a couple other places with my tripod. And that's the day. And then I go pack my bags. It's tomorrow I leave for Switzerland. So wish us luck today. Talk to you later.
After the Spanish steps, we headed to the Mouth of Truth. Since there's always a line, and we weren't sure how strict they would be with posing for pictures, I read that you had to pay €2 for one picture, which turns out not to be true. They do have a donation box, and there is a line of people, so you can't, you know, spend an hour trying to get the right picture there. Anyway, I got some video before they opened the gates. And then we got in line, took our pictures. Oh, yes, you don't have to pay, but I would suggest dropping some donation in the box. Probably buys you a couple more seconds to take your pictures. We got some nice pictures, and then hurry out of line and into the church, which is, they make you go through the church, the Santa Maria in Cosmedin Church. Had to write that down, or type it. Why do I say write it down? We don't write anything down anymore. But yes, you're directed inside the church, which is lovely and peaceful after you take your pictures. So, Mouth of Truth and the church.
This opens 15 minutes. Here we are.
Cut to. After a dramatic fight on a barge and a sad farewell, we return to the palace.
Here is where Joe Bradley drops off Princess Anne to go home. Now you get to see the other side. So the whole crew was back here. Parked there. She ran away. And of course again, this lovely place. Now I'm being my own photographer. Using a 10-second timer to recreate her run back home.
So, as I'm walking around Rome doing the Roman holiday thing, doing these little photo shoots, I just really love to imagine just the whole crew that was behind the scenes for this movie, for any movie. It's the part that fascinates me, that you don't see all the people behind the camera who had a part in making something happen. And I don't know, there's just, I long to see that part, like the behind the scenes documentary of Roman Holiday. It's just, I don't know, all those people who work and they're invisible, they're behind the scenes, you don't see them, you might not think about them, just everyone. I mean, you know, the location scout who decided, you know, down this alley we should shoot towards the palace, or chose that palace, or just all the little jobs in filmmaking are so integral, important, and I appreciate you all. just wonder if anyone who worked on Roman holiday in the US or here in Rome is still alive. You know, I'd love to hear stories. This period of movie making is disappearing now. Everyone's getting old and dying. But if there's anyone out there, I would love to hear stories. So you know where to find me. Now, I'm gonna head on over to my last location for today, near the river, for the dancing on the barge thing. So there's no barge, but I have an idea for a picture, so I'm gonna go over there now. See you later.
So the palace at the end of the movie is not the same one as at the beginning. That was the Galleria Barberini, and at the end of the movie, the final scene is shot at the Galleria Colonna. Beautiful, gorgeous place, and only two movies have ever been shot there, and I can't remember what the second one is. But it's gorgeous inside, and I visited twice. The guards are super friendly. One of them helped me take some pictures when I went there alone, and he did a fantastic job, honestly. The place is amazing to see in color. I feel like had it been in color for the movie, it would have been so distracting. You hardly pay attention to it in the movie, but when you're there in person, it's overload. But it's beautiful, so that's worth a visit. I was told, I don't totally believe him, but one of the guards told me that I was the first Roman holiday fan that he had seen visit the place. Maybe because I looked like I had stepped out of the 50s, and maybe other fans are more discreet. But it's not on the radar for Audrey Hepburn fans.
So this is where they shot the last scene in Roman holiday. It's impressive, isn't it? I've been getting stopped a lot. People take pictures of me and with me because I'm dressed kind of princessy. So here's the gallery, and here are the stairs. This is where she met the press. If you watch the movie, which I haven't seen lately, but you'll see that painting in the background. I found a picture on Google trying to see what I could recognize, so I saw that one. But obviously, you'll probably see everything. Down the hall of it. I think this was actually once a bedroom. I would not mind sleeping there.
Roman holiday tour. So I hope you enjoyed it, and please go check out the other videos. I've got London, and I will have Switzerland and Holland very soon. It's been an exhausting summer, but it's been fun, and I feel like I've kind of contributed to the Audrey Hepburn community in a way, because there's just a gap, I think, for what I'm doing now. These little videos, my little tour videos, these locations. So even though this is not professional, professional documentary quality, I hope they're enjoyable. I hope you had fun visiting these locations with me. And please find me on Instagram, and you can travel along with me. I'm always doing something interesting. I'm still posting pictures from this trip. In October 2019, I'll be posting all my Roman holiday pictures. And yes, this whole thing is just a part of my larger goal right now of playing the part of Audrey Hepburn. So, we're doing Audrey Hepburn overload this year. So anyone who loves Audrey, just come follow me right now, and you will get a daily dose of whatever I'm doing. So I'll see you around. Thanks for watching. Ciao.